extensively. We had a little conference with Michael McFaul, you know, the former U.S. ambassador to Russia, about this very question of whether Putin represents a new ideology, or whether he's simply an opportunist who's using ideas to further his own, you know, power and interests. I think a lot of American observers of Russia tend to believe the latter, that there isn't really a consistent doctrine underlying Putin, and that, you know, he's a kleptocrat, you know, meaning highly corrupt, and he and his friends, you know, are basically interested in protecting, you know, their resources and getting more of them. But I tend to think that he has developed something like an ideology which is based on conservative social principles. So, for example, opposition to gay marriage is something that he has made a centerpiece, really, of his social program. And opposition to a decadent West that has promoted gay marriage is something, you know, he argues in Russia itself. But what's interesting is that's very attractive to a lot of audiences outside of Russia. So, for example, there are a bunch of Christian, conservative Christian groups in the United States that work very closely with Russia to promote, you know, to push back on gay marriage and to promote traditional family values. Other, you know, things about Surkov sovereign democracy, you know, the idea that no country should be allowed to tell any other country how to run, you know, their system. No one should criticize anyone for human rights violations. That's something also that a lot of other countries are very sympathetic to. So I do think that there is a bit of a, you know, it's hard to call it an ideology because it's not that well developed, but there's a set of conservative social values that I think Putin has come to represent in the eyes of a lot of conservatives around the world, and I think that that has given his attempt to project Russian influence extra, it's accelerated the projection of Russian influence. Because, you know, he couldn't interfere in American politics unless there were Americans who wanted his support, and there are plenty of them, you know, on the Christian right. By the way, I actually met Mr. Surkov in the Kremlin. This was probably, I would say, maybe 10 or 12 years ago, and we had a long discussion. He actually had read, you know, a couple of my books, and he told me all about sovereign democracy, and I must say at the time, it seemed like a completely incoherent doctrine that was simply being used to justify whatever Putin wanted to do. But like I said, I think it's now evolved into, you know, a sort of conservative social doctrine that also aligns with, you know, Russia's authoritarian political system.
Thanks.